do the mass in here. Oh, okay. But today it failed, so I'm here for the to live stream the new mass.
Speak about the needs of the diocese Lord Jesus, you call us each day to new life in you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. Fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things, and above all things, we may attain your promises, which surpass every human desire. We ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, as one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
As we continue our prayer today, I invite you to remember along with me the intention of Diana Magistro and Mary Carbucci, for whom our Mass is being offered.
The first reading is from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just, for my salvation is about to come, my justice about to be revealed. The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord ministering to loving the name of the Lord and becoming his servants. All who keep the Sabbath free from profanation and hold my covenant. Then I will bring to my holy mountain and make joyfully my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
inasmuch as I am the apostle to the Gentiles. I glory in my ministry in order to make my race jealous, and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? For the gifts and the call of God are irrevocable, just as you once disobeyed God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience. So they have now disobeyed in order that, by virtue of the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God delivered all to disobedience, that he might have mercy on all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, have pity on me. My daughter has a demon within her, and I need your help. And Jesus' initial response is not expected. He doesn't respond at all. He doesn't say a word. I think it's probably, though, because he was wondering how the disciples were going to respond. And we see that. First of all, the woman wasn't one of the in crowd. She wasn't of the right background at that time. She didn't belong to the correct country club, if you will. And so the disciples, they appear, Lord, let's get rid of this woman. She's bothering us. All she's doing is following us. And then Jesus says, what is very important for you and for me to realize today, he says, I've not come for those doing well. I have come for the lost sheep of Israel. And then the woman expresses once again her faith in the Lord. And Jesus says, your faith has healed you, and your faith healed your daughter. And the woman was blessed. Jesus blessed the woman because of her faith. We go through life, and at times we come up with some very difficult and upsetting situations in life. I think we all agree we're going through one of those right now. And as much as we don't like it, as much as we don't like what we're going through, the Lord still calls us to be a people of faith, to trust in Him. Maybe not to get exactly what we want, and we'd like this over tomorrow, but to know that God is with us. Because He came for the lost sheep. And at times in our life, we are lost. And the shepherd, though, is there always to take our hand. To take our hand. And the shepherd takes our hand directly at times, and sometimes through others. And that's why I'm so delighted that we have a representative here today from Amor Nacion. The Lord, through Amor Nacion for the last 40 years, has taken the hand of some of the poorest, come on, won't you, some of the poorest of God's poor, particularly in Haiti and in the Dominican Republic. Once each year, in all the parishes throughout the diocese, a missionary or mission group is invited to share the needs of God's poor and to ask us as a community of faith, to ask us to help them to bring dignity to the poor and to meet the needs of some of God's poor. And this year, here at St. John the Baptist, Amor Nacion was invited, was assigned, to be able to share with this parish. So I hope as you listen to your words, your beautiful words about the ministry. I got to know Amor Nacion in my first parish, Little Flower, when I was ordained. I know you'll never believe this, but I was ordained 37 years ago. But when I was ordained 37 years ago, Amor Nacion was involved in Little Flower Parish in the Gables, and still they are there. And so I'm delighted to be able to present to you Janelle, right? Janelle, who's a member of Amor Nacion and actually the coordinator of it now. And she's going to share with us the beautiful ministry, the beautiful work of Amor Nacion, and then ask for help. Janelle, welcome.
Good morning. It's a blessing for me to be able to be here with all of you today to share with you our love of God, which we live very explicitly in our commitment with the poor. I'd like to first thank Father Gary, Monsignor Kelly, and the entire community of St. John the Baptist for welcoming me here, for opening your hearts and your home. This is your home to me and to Amor Nacion, and to have this opportunity to share a little bit about our work. Amor Nacion is a community of lay missionaries based here in the Archdiocese of Miami. We have been working in the Dominican Republic and in the northwest of Haiti in our sister diocese of Portobet for over 40 years in Haiti. We dedicate ourselves to assisting with projects that provide education. We have about 30 schools in Haiti alone. We have a couple that we support in the Dominican Republic. Nutrition, providing a hot meal a day for many children and families. Evangelization, supporting the efforts of our mother church. Medical assistance, and projects that make clean water available to communities lacking resources. Our charism is also making us present the universal dimension of faith and commitment that must lie churches that live and communities that live in difficult situations, situations that make our Christian and human hearts cry. We try to bring awareness to the gospel's call to solidarity, to justice, and to the affirmation of human dignity. On short-term missions, we encounter Jesus in the other. This encounter fuels the missionary zeal and challenges us to engage with and to empower our brothers and sisters. We live in solidarity with the communities that we serve, meaning we live in the communities, we accompany them in their day-to-day lives, and accompany them in their joys, their hopes, and their struggles. We also draw awareness to and support social justice through our support of education, helping give every child a chance at a better future. And it's not just children that trying to get to a school that may be closest by, but also communities that are marginalized in urban areas where people may go around and never walk through the neighborhood. Through our work in our company in these communities, as we read today's gospel, I just kept remembering an encounter that I had myself. And this is a few years back, but I remember that every day we would go to Mass, as we normally do, the company of the community. Usually in many of the churches, a lot of just little old ladies that come to Mass every day. But I remember noticing that week that there was a little boy that would come. He was about 11 years old, and he stuck out to me because he would come to Mass alone, and he wasn't properly dressed. His clothes was in tatters. And so, of course, I asked the old ladies, and I just kind of asked about him. So, this little boy, I noticed you all taking care of him. I noticed you, as Mass would end and it was on a busy street, I would notice that the older ladies would make sure that he would cross safely. And so, as I asked the ladies about him, they said, oh, he's known as the mudo, or the mute one. So, he can't hear and he can't speak, but he comes and, we try to take care of him. Every morning, as is the case with so many of these children, he's pretty much cast out. And since he couldn't hear, assuming he really didn't attend any school because he had special needs. But in thinking about this, his presence and the ladies' care and concern for him reminded me of our work in God's world. We're called to care for the least. We're called to care for them because they are God's children and our brothers and sisters. Every Mass, I would find myself praying for this little boy, that God may keep him safe. And one thing that I must note about Dominican being in church in the Republic is that when it came time for the sign of peace, it didn't matter if you were a long-standing community member or a new acquaintance. Everybody was greeted with a hug and a kiss. No matter how hot it was, and being American, it was pretty hot for us, and I would be a little bit embarrassed, but they would always embrace us. And I remember the first time I gave a sign of peace to this little boy, that we were able to exchange it. It's not even that I could give it to him. And in that exchange, I saw a beautiful light and radiance in his eyes. This radiance that just reminded me, Jesus is here. Jesus is within this little boy. Jesus is within this little boy that may be cast out by his family, may be cast out by society, but we are all called to be members of one body, one church, and to embrace one another. In my work as part of Amor y Pasión, building relationships with communities and accompanying them, I found that what we give and we share, it in no way compares to the riches that we receive in encountering Jesus in the poor. In seeing Jesus' joyous face in the children that we serve, in encountering Jesus in the cross as we learn about and experience their suffering, and finally, Jesus' resurrection as we, as our faith is renewed in sharing with these communities, in serving the last, the lost, Jesus' beloved. We ask that you take part in this mission today in a couple of ways. One is the simplest. I ask for your prayers. I ask that you may pray for us, for our missionary work, and for the communities that we serve, that we may be able to continue to do this. I also ask that you consider the missionary call. Jesus calls all of us. We're a lay missionary group. So we're comprised of everyday folks, teachers, professionals, doing missionary work by virtue of the call in our baptism. So I ask you to consider volunteering with us. And finally, collaborating with your support in the second collection. Your collaboration, it may seem like it's not much. For us, it's a huge fountain of hope that can only be shown, as the teacher salary. So a little bit goes a long way, so I ask that you collaborate and please help us. Thank you for your time. Thank you for opening your home and your hearts to us. May God bless you all.
Thank you, Janelle, very much, very much. I think it's so important that you make a distinction between lay missionaries and other missionaries, and that we are all called to be missionaries. So often we think of missionaries being the ones dressed like I am, or women with a veil on, but Amor Nacion has always been 99% a lay missionary. And you've done so much good work throughout the years for the people that you serve. So thank you, and thank you for clarifying for us that when you went to give the handshake or the embrace of peace to the little boy, that it was something you didn't simply go to give, but you went to receive as well. We reach out and we so often give to the poor, and we try to help the poor, we should. We also need to realize that the poor are there to help us through their prayers, through their support. People who come to my own diocese in Jamaica, they come down to the mission groups, and this will, I'm sure, resonate with you. They come down to the mission moments. And at the end of the week, they say, you know, we came to minister to the people there, but it is they who minister to us, just by the way they live. And that's what that little boy has done for you, and probably for so many others. So thank you, and I hope you will join me in being generous today to help to continue the beautiful ministry of Amor Nacion, lay ministers like yourselves, lay ministers. To be able to reach out and to care for God's poor. Would you stand now and join with me as we profess our faith in the Apostles' Creed? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. My friends, recalling the faith of the Canaanite woman in today's Gospel, we now lift up our hearts to the Father with assurance that our prayers will be heard.
For the Church, may the grace and mercy of the Holy Spirit continue to strengthen her in faith and unity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations throughout the world, may God grant them a spirit of reconciliation. Collaboration. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families experiencing strife, may the peace of Christ bring an end to division and repair broken relationships.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, especially in our families and our parish, that God's healing touch may bring them peace and comfort. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may they experience the mercy of God and rest in His eternal peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the victims and their families of the massive explosion in Beirut, in Lebanon, this past week, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Well, loving God, we make these prayers with great trust and confidence in your care for us. Please hear us this day and all the days of our lives, and bring us your loving care and help through Christ Jesus the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated.
for the grace and glory of your name, for our good and all of our souls.
Receive our offerings, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you've given, we may merit to receive your very self. That we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Give an heart to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. It's our duty and salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you've given us Jesus, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners. And he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all of your daughters and your sons. And so with the angels and the saints, we praise you, as together now we sing. When supper was ended, he took the chalice, and again he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his friends and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. May your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. And remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith is known to you alone. Welcome them to rejoice in the light of your presence, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of your life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the apostles and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, with him, and in him, O God. Now, as Jesus taught us, together we pray. Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant peace in our day. May your mercy keep us free from sin and protect us from all distress, as we await in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory is yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, my peace I give you, my peace I leave with you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
May the peace of the good Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. Let's offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Today's second collection is in support of the missionary efforts of Ennore and ASEAN. We invite your most generous giving to assist the diocese in providing the resources needed to continue their ministry and missionary efforts for the church. The church will be tented for termites from Tuesday, August 18 through Thursday, August 20. Daily Mass will be held in the parish hall during this time. We appreciate your patience. Respect Life is in need of donations. Please see the bulletin for details.
Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, O Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven. He who lives and reigns with you and Holy Spirit is one God forever and ever.
Amen.
And I enjoy the parish in thanking you for your love, your care, your support of this lay mission group that does so much. I'm Lord Axio. May God bless you. You for your goodness and care. If someone wasn't ready to do so this week and